Hey all, welcome. And in this session, we would be building a brand new application, and that's going to be Flaticon Clone. What is Flaticon? Flaticon is a service which offers millions of free images, and that too copyrighted free means it doesn't have any copyrighted material, and we can use it in our applications or website, that too for free. So that's the best part of it, and we are creating the same kind of service in our application. And today's application is going to be Flaticon Clone through AppLab or Coder.org. So it's really so good that we are able to create such good application through AppLab or Coder.org. So let me first introduce you much more about that site that you are much aware. I hope that most of you are already aware of it, but if you are not, then don't worry, I'm going to explain it. So here's the Flaticon website. You can go to the website flaticon.com just to check features, I mean its images, and here it offers millions of free items, and we are going to create the same application, same application in AppLab of Coder.org. And you know, most of the applications which have been made earlier and the icons which have been used for creating such applications, I have took those images from here itself, because it contains images which are copyrighted free, so it doesn't contain any copyrighted material. Otherwise, what happens is, if we download an image from Google and if it contains copyrighted material, then it can cause, if you publish that application to Google Play Store, then it may cause some copyrighted issues. That is why it's better to either create your own icons or just take it from services which offer free icons, and that too copyrighted free. So that's my suggestion for you all, because you all are growing developers, so you should know these things. You all should be aware of these things. If you are already aware, then that's pretty good, but if you are not, then of course gaining knowledge is not something bad. So without no more delays, let's get started. So here's the Flaticon Clone website. Let's go to the design section and import screen. So here we are going to import the screen, and because I've already made and designed the screen, so making them again is going to be a little difficult task. Not difficult task, but time consuming task. And yes, of course, you're going to get this import screen link in the description. So in the description, there would be a link. Just go to that link and get the project link. And that too for free, because of course, it's going to be. So click on next and just import everything, all the images, all the assets, and all the screens. And just click on import. So I'm just going to just tell you all the screens. I will just explain you a bit of all the screens, so that if you don't import the screen, then you can just do it easily. You can just make it on your own. So here there are splash screen, and mainly all the applications have a splash screen, so that's what we are going to do in our application. Next, so this is screen number one. Now screen number two, we have added some options. So these are the options. The user can go through any option, any required option. Any option which the user feels like going to. Click the button and they would be going there. Now as we have four options, so four screens for them, and each screen has the required assets required. Okay, so you can just get these assets, and you can get these assets from any website or from Google, but be careful, as I have told you that you should always take use of copyrighted free images, so just make sure of it. And now, so here I have four backgrounds, right? Can see because here I have a back button, so you should have it in each of your screen. So let's insert it, back button. Now because even you may have imported the screens from the link which has been given to you in description, so first add these back buttons. That's going to be, if you should do it, so that if the user is done with the screen, then it can go back instead of reloading this application. And please take care of these tips which I am sharing to you always. That's really going to be helpful. Now here as well. Just click on choose and go to icons and just search for pack. Simply this you need to do. I'm so sorry what I did. Oh gosh. Well now here can just now I'm just inserting this icon, any of this icon. It really doesn't matter. And you can change its icon color. That it gives a good look. I guess black is only good. Now here you need to click on this image and just go to icon and search for black. And then this screen, and again just insert an image component. Here it is. Just decrease its size, put it here. And search for back. And that's what you need to do. I hope you have done it here. Now let's go to the code section. And here in the code section, let's start coding our application. So I am assuming that you all are beginners or you all are comfortable with the block section, because I have received many requests of making the videos with this block on. It blocks only, okay? Let's do it. So first of all, we are adding the functionality of splash screen. So let's go to the screen number one and add the functionality of splash screen. So what we are doing is going in the control tab, and here just go to set timeout. Just drag this component or block, whatever it is, set timeout block, and go to UI controls, and now simply you just need to search for set screen. Yes, that after 1 second it should set screen number 2, and that's so simple. The codes for adding a functional, the codes for adding a splash screen is really so simple. So let's go to screen number 2, and this work is also very easy. So simply just drag the block which is on event. That on event, when this is clicked, we will be adding it. Just have patience. So yeah, on event when button number 1 is clicked, then it should set screen which is background. Alright, so background. Now simply you need to duplicate this block 3 more times, because there are 4 options there. So just to save our time, we would be doing it. Now on event when button number 2 is clicked, button number 3 is clicked, and button number 3 is clicked, and button number 4 is clicked, then let's just cross check if it's correct here, then just do it accordingly, respectively, just do all these things. Icons, then here for button number 3 it's education, and for button number 4 it is miscellaneous. Alright. Actually pronouncing it is little, this word is, this term itself is little weird. Just forget it. Now next, let's go to the option that is background. Now here, first let's add the codes for all the back buttons. Okay, that on event when image number 24 is clicked, then it should set screen number 2. That's so simple. And now you need to duplicate this block 3 more times in order to save our time. 1, 2, 3, and that's our job is done. Now let's go to each screen. Now education, here it is image 25. Now icons, image 26. And now let's go to this screen. It is image 27. So whenever you hover over any component, then you will get to know its ID. And that's going to be easy. Instead of going back to design tab and just collecting its ID names, it's better just we are able to get to know all these things here itself. So that's quite good. Now next, what are we doing is, let's go to the screen which is background, and here on event when image number 1 is clicked. Now here we need to apply our frame that on event when image number 2 is clicked. Then what's going to happen? Could you guys tell? We're on event when image number 1 is clicked. So let's just do it step by step. On event when image number 1 is clicked, then it's going to, let's just scroll a little down. It's going to show the element which is image 1, this component itself, and hide all the other elements, all the other images, which is image number 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Image 2, 3, 4, and 5. So just duplicate it 3 more times. And do you know this? Do you know how to duplicate? Just do it like this and click on Ctrl plus C and then Ctrl plus V. Okay. So image number 2, image number 3, image number 4. And image number 5. Done. And next, set property. We will track this block. Set property of image number 1, its width as 350 and its height as 350. Now let me show you what will happen. Let's click on run, go to backgrounds, and as soon as you click on this image, see what happens is this image gets enlarged and all the other images are hidden. And the best part is, now what the user can do is, now suppose the user is using this application. Alright, the user is using this application and then he wants to save any particular image. So what he will do is, he will simply take a snip of this image. How? Just take a screenshot or snip in order to save this image. So that's how the users can download the icons. So this is one way. Now the second method through which the users can download this icon is either by taking a snip of it or taking a screenshot. And the second method is, you can just hear add a button that as soon as they click on this image, then all the other elements are hidden. And one more element is shown here, that download button. So as soon as they click on this download button, you can hear, just put the link that on event when the download button is clicked, then open the URL of this image downloads link. So you can just go to Google and just get the link of this image. How you will get the link of this image? It's very simple. Either you can do this by Google Drive, or there are many more services which offer this thing. Simply what you can do is just go to any website. There are download, I mean it gives users the file to download or the link to download. So you can just simply do that. So there are many methods, there are multiple, or there are various things to do this. It's not very hard. You can insert its download link here by adding a button that is download. Done. Or even you can here add a label that download the image by taking a snip. Now I have given you so many ideas of how you can make your app more attractive, but now I'm just making it as simple as I can, because I'm just telling you the ideas like how you can create such application, and now after that you can add your creativities and make it even more better. And don't forget to share your updated versions of this applications with us, either via mail or in Discord or in comment section. We would be glad to see your new updated versions. And if you don't want to share your project publicly to everyone, because people copy, I know. So what you can do then next is just share it in our email and get the reviews, I mean then get the remarks by us. Then we will give you the remarks of the application or any other thing which you can do it to, in order to make it much more important. So that's all you can do, and that's all we can do it from our side. We can give you more compliments or comments on your project so that you can even make it more, much more better. Done. I hope you all get it. Now the next part we can do is just click on backgrounds and just you can just simply do it. I hope that's clear to all of you. Done. That's cool. Now we need to do it for each and every image. So I'm doing it for others as well, for a few more, so that you get an idea. So on event when image number 2 is clicked, then it's going to hide. It's going to show the image, which is image 2, and hide all the other images. And just make a change here. Image 2. Let's just check it if a code is running all fine. Go to backgrounds and just click on this image. Yes, it's working all fine. That's cool. Now because its y axis is very down, so even you can do that. Go to set property, or you can actually set the position of it. You can set its position, you can set its y-axis as well as in middle. If it's so down, it's too down, then you can do that thing as well. Let's just check it if it's, let's try doing it. So just let's just check it. Do it. To be in, I guess in middle it would be better, 200. Right, 200, let's just do it. That would be, in exactly in middle, okay? And here do it 350, and then now you all can just remove these blocks, the above two blocks, because that requirement has been fulfilled by this block. Alright, Let's just remove it. Let's run it to check if the code is working perfectly fine. Click on this. So here. Wait, let's just reset and run again. So it has shifted, that's right. So I mean, it has shifted so long. So what you can do is go to image, I mean go to background, do it. Its X position to be 0. Let's go to design to get all the things in a better view, in a better look. Its X position minus 30 and 125. Alright, minus 30 and 125. Let's check it out now. Yeah, now it's fine. Okay, so that's how you can do. Now guys, see, if I will do it for each and every log, I mean for each and every image, then it's really going to consume a lot of time and the video is going to be so long. So now, here's your today's task. Your today's task is that you have to make it for all. Complete it for all. So let me give you a few tips so that you can do it in a much better way. So first of all, what you will do is, you will duplicate this block many more times according to the number of more images left. And now you will change here the component name and show element the same component name which is reflected over here. Then accordingly change these names as well. Okay, I hope you won't get any error, or if you get any error or if you find any difficulty doing it, feel free to contact us and get your doubt solved by us. Simply in the Discord you can ask your doubt to us, or you can mail us with your doubt, or even you can comment us. And sometimes due to some issues we are not able to respond. So if suppose anytime we don't respond within 2 days, if we don't respond to your query, then please reply us again and just remind us again to solve your doubt. Because sometimes some issues actually happen, it occurs. That is why sometimes we are not able to respond to some query. So just reply to that message and just tell it that please solve this error. Alright, thank you everyone. And with this, and actually from past few months we were really inactive, so now it won't happen. In Discord also we were inactive, and in YouTube also we were inactive due to some issues, but now it won't happen. And if we don't reply in 2 days, then please again reply us. Thing that I have already told you. And yes, but I hope you all got it, that how to do. You need to do it for everything, because if I will do it again, then it's going to take a lot of time and I don't want the video to be so long. So you need to do it for education and all these things. And I have already told you the method or by which how you can enlarge the screen and how to hide all the other components. So now it's your task to apply your creativity, and that's of course your creativity which is going to be in mine, because practicing is what will make you really perfect here. If you will just copy paste the things which I have already done, then it's not really going to be helpful for you. if you practice on your own and apply your own creativities, then it's really going to be very good for you, for your future as well as for you. So make sure that you do it, you complete it, and don't copy the codes. Please don't copy the codes, otherwise it's really not going to be helpful for you, because just copying and pasting the application and the codes will really not help you. And that way we would be little discouraged to share the project links with you guys. If we see that you all are just copying our codes, then that, I mean, in that way we would stop sharing project links with you all. So it's better that you try your own creativity. We just share project links with you guys so that you all can just check if you are getting any error, or try solving by yourself the errors which you are faced. And the errors which you face, you can just deal with them. That is why we share project links. But we don't have any intending. We don't think that you always, I mean, we all guys are in a belief that you will just take it as a support, as I mean, a support, so that you can just cross check if your app is getting error. But not in an intention that you all will just copy the code. That will really discourage us. And we would then stop sharing project links with you guys. I don't want to repeat all the things which I have already told you. So I hope you all got it, and just try creating the applications on yourself and don't copy the codes. That's what I'm telling you, so that in future you will be able to create much more better applications than anyone. And that's, we are just, I mean, just saying it just for your better sake, that you would be able to create much more better application applying your creativities instead of just copying, pasting, and just sharing to everyone that, see, I have built this application. That's not telling you yourself know that you have not built that application. Alright, so I don't want to extend the video duration. So thank you everyone, and I hope you got the point which I'm trying to deliver to you all guys. Thank you. And you can expect the next video soon. And also share your ideas or share your any request of any applications to be built by us. And if you want us to build, I mean, to publish a tutorial of any application of your app request, then in the description there would be a link, a form link, and then you can share, and we will be surely doing it as soon as we can. Thanks for watching.